Your impression. Yeah. Hi, we're here with Richard Gere. Nice to see you.
I'm just having my tea, we were all falling asleep after lunch.
It's true. We've had a long engaging day at Mind and Life 18.
It's an espresso.
Espresso machine.
So can you tell us a little about your experience? And you've been coming to Mind and Life for many years?
I've lost track. I don't know how many I've been to, but enough that the players are all friends of mine at this point. I think this is a particularly good one because it's going directly at the meditative experience and quantifying it in ways that I see His Holiness and Thupten Jinpa and Alan groping to put many things in layman's terms that would normally be communicated in purely Buddhist terms, in Sanskrit, Muslim, and some in Tibetan. I think it's interesting for all of us to hear it from that perspective and the kind of also struggle to make that happen. The struggle to talk to scientists that are, okay, they're not coming from the same place we are, so let's explain it from this angle. But I think that process, those of us who have been practicing for some time, are also expanding the horizons of possibility, of understanding what actually is happening when we're meditating.
On the inside, yeah. Yeah, great.
Can I ask you also, what do you think the value of these meetings in terms of your participation? How do you see this continuing on in the future with His Holiness and beyond?
I think His Holiness actually articulated quite well. From his side, certainly there's an aspect of Buddhism that has to do with the mystery and kind of deeper things that are probably never knowable. But there certainly is an aspect of Buddhism which is pure science, it's pure logic, it's pure cause and effect. And that is equal to any other science. So I think for people to understand it's Buddhist science that is engaging Western science. And there are certain prejudices that are inherent in both sides, dealing with anything. So I think the evolution of a common language, in some sense, probably even inventing new linguistics to deal with concepts that can bridge culture, can bridge points of view, could be incredibly important. I mean, we're in the beginning of something.
Right.
I think about the times when the early Latsawas, the early interpreters and translators were translating Sanskrit and Pali into Tibet, totally exploring in the jungle, coming through machetes. And this is still the period we're in now, taking these concepts and languages and terminology, points of view, and trying to translate them into other languages. Very beginning stages. This is really the